Hey folks, today it's about how you can remove tracks from Bitwig without deleting. And as you can see in this project here, I have a lot of tracks and groups, and it takes a lot of CPU power. And what you usually do is you try to bounce down some audio, and then you get rid of the VST plugins or devices on your tracks. So I try to bounce down this complete group track from the drums here, and when I hit play, you can hear the audio is crackling and Bitwig is struggling with playing all the different tracks at the same time. And even then, Bitwig can bounce down this audio flawlessly. So let's do this. So now that we have bounced down the audio into this audio file here, we can now get rid of this whole group track. And what you usually do is you go in each track and then you hit shift and click, and then you can deactivate the current device. But that's a bit cumbersome, so we try to deactivate this whole group chain with this button here. And when we uncheck this active check mark here, then you can see we have deactivated all tracks inside our group track, and we save a lot of CPU usage. So we have our deactivated group track, disabled group track, and we have our bounced audio in here, so we can now start to play back our project again and have no problems. What we want to do now is we want to get rid of these type of tracks, because when you have multiple disabled tracks, maybe like this and this, and then you have all the new tracks with the bounced audio from these disabled tracks, it becomes pretty confusing fast. So what you do now is you use this button down here, which reads show deactivated tracks, and you hit this and all your disabled tracks are gone. They are still inside the project, they are just hidden. So when you want to bring them back, just hit this button again and you see them. And it's a pretty nice thing, because can always go back to your original tracks with all the VSTs inside, with all your settings, and can bounce all the audio tracks again. I think it's pretty nice, and it's not only useful for this use case, you can also use this for DJ sets or live acts, or when you are at your sound design stage, when you want to create a lot of crazy sounds in with multiple devices and effects and so on. And you can leave this all inside your project and just deactivate it, hide it, and you can always go back to it and bounce down the sounds again. Pretty nice. Yeah, and that's it for this video. I hope you learned something new about Bitwig, and yeah, try this out. It's a pretty nice feature. Until next time, see you and bye.